Also, Jahresrückblick mit Erdgeist, okay. Konstanze,
Returns.
Linus.
From Erdgeist, Konstanze, Linge, Frank Triggerst und Hackfeed.
Cyber!
Abfahrt!
Herzlich willkommen und einen wunderschönen and a night morning today with more Cyber Cyber, which is also quite in all the other days, and a small change in the people who are here. We surprise with new people here every day. We have got a new person here.
So
we don't have other speakers on the podium, but also one of our big
Vorstand des Herzens natürlich. Das möchte ich dazu sagen.
Und Prozedere hat sich trotzdem nicht so
the procedure doesn't have changed a lot. We'll go chronological, but not only. In the beginning, we talk about how many members there are here. Some numbers from the secret databases of the CCC. This year again, we have more members as last year and not a small number of new members.
Hey, Konstanze,
didn't we want to do something complete else this morning? Okay, let's do another. Hi, I'm Hackpete and I'm here for the first time and I didn't know that I was allowed to be here 10 minutes ago.
Das ist natürlich eine dreiste Lüge.
That's a lie. He was prepared for weeks. And he is, of course, always well prepared. So, here we see on this slide from our office.
Hello,
I'm the Erdgeist. I work on the Datenschleuder and I'm here back after a year.
Ich bin der Linus.
I'm Linus. My hobbies are riding, swimming and computers.
Ja, das ist auch noch Frank.
Right. That's your also right to ask. Okay, completely improvised. Okay, the new members over the last 12 months cleared by the 12 by the peak 12 few months weeks before the of
wir machen mal wieder große Raten, wo kommt dieser
Communication Congress? Where is the peak in the early spring from?
Ich höre.
I hear.
Ich weiß, ich kenne.
Does nobody know?
Die sind noch nicht wach.
They're not awake yet.
Ich finde aber gute Vorsitze ist valide, oder?
Oh.
Natürlich, ganz genau.
Of course,
also,
exactly.
Nicht nur, dass wir zu der
not only
Strafanzeige
that
gegen
we
Chef
sued against the
und weiterer Verdächtiger
government and about secret services and other people of other suspects. Okay, we haven't started yet, but I can't finish one sentence because somebody talks into my sentences.
Ich meine, echt, na gut.
Dabei hat Frank gerade extra Bonbons verteilt. Ich bin ganz still, weil ich
Frank extra shared Bonbons. And so we can't talk.
Okay.
Not only have we got a lot of new members, but also if we look at the mails from all years, we got the most letters or emails during the last year. They were a bit different about the how the press reported about it. I just wanted to
Spitzen in der Statistik
show the high points in the statistics. You can also try to guess the second tip.
Ich glaube, da könnt ihr nicht drauf kommen. Okay.
You can't guess that. Hack Pete has to explain it. Oh, me again? Oh, that's probably because we had a really successful Erfahrkreis who owned a Bürgernetzverein and they all joined us. So we see a real nice peak here where we just own them. Okay. Okay, the Erfa Paderborn can feel good now. The Erfa Paderborn will announce later. Here we see the Erfas, and the smaller points in the maps are the Karstreffs. And also, next to it, on the right, you see the entrance area, which are to the Erfas. And the still available white spots on the German map. But we also see this anomaly towards the east, where we diversify over the German borders. With Hackbeat, we do have two new Erfas. Yes. So we grow. Was I supposed to be prepared for this question? Yeah. I think we go forward to new.
Also wir sehen, dass natürlich die Mitgliedschaft in den Erfas unterschiedlich verteilt ist.
There are different memberships in the Erfas. There are still the big one in Hamburg and in Berlin. We also see that Munich is still growing up, and we have another rather larger membership in Cologne.
Ist einfach ganz gut verteilt.
So I think that's divided up quite nicely. So the big Erfas also have more happenings, there's more things, so they also grow faster. Aliens, which is meant on the, are members who are not part of a certain Erfa. Around two-thirds don't claim part of an Erfa. But we recommend you to join an Erfa so that money flows towards the Erfas more directly. Erfas are Erfahrungsaustauschkreis, so, which is a strange name. And those who want to join an Erfa should do that over the our forms.
So we're also becoming more international, as you can see by the global map here. So we're spreading without Germany. You can see here the memberships with in other countries like Switzerland and Austria, obviously German-speaking countries are the strongest, but we also have members in Hong Kong, Singapore, etc. And we'd like to keep these statistics and watching them. I don't want this gadget. So anyone else? So we tried to do a different kind of evaluation this time, which I find quite stunning. Now, as the member base is diversifying, we also have quite a large variety in the kind of emailed addresses that are submitted. So getting GMX and Google. these are the burner email addresses that people tell us for ones to throw away. Well, in any case, or at least Posteo, a German private email provider, has already reached Top
5. Keine einzige Anon-Box-Adresse dabei.
So, not a single Anon-Box address, remarkably. Well, they only have five members.
Yeah. Bevor wir zu so einer gewissen, wir kommen zu so einer gewissen Statistik der Tweets, die wir dieses Mal gemacht haben, einfach um ein bisschen zu zeigen.
We're just giving a short overview over the tweets, the like the public actions that have been taking place in the course of the last year. Like, we just want to highlight what got the most public attention, like our top nine. But our press work in general, we've been getting a slightly smaller amount of press inquiries. It's the press at CCC address. There's a lot of obviously spam inquiries, but just looking at pure press inquiries,
die Leute, die bearbeiten, sind derzeit 10, von denen etwa die Hälfte wirklich sehr aktiv diese Presseliste bearbeiten und versuchen Antworten zu finden.
10 people like trying to reply and also obviously refer press to experts within CCC who can maybe answer questions.
So ein bisschen vergrößert.
So, our press team has actually increased in the last 2 years. But there's been no like notable increase in press interest.
Ja, selber mehr raushauen.
So that just means for us that for social media and just our own channels, we would like to provide a bit more information, like coming from our side.
Hat der CCC was dazu zu sagen, Anfragen zum Glück etwas vermindert.
Well, also in den but maybe it's also not that bad that the kind of a bit fell over somewhere on the other end of the world kind of inquires what does the CCC have to say about that. Well, we don't have to feel like obliged to comment on everything. And that kind of a generic statement inquiry, that's become a bit less, so maybe more targeted questions.
Ich denke, da setzt dann auch so ein gewisser Lerneffekt ein, also die Anfragen, die wir bekommen haben zu den...
So, actually, there's been quite a learning curve for the press as well, maybe, what kind of inquiries we receive. Well, this annual report is also kind of justification or trying to recap what we've been doing the past year.
Ungefähr 2 Jahre eigentlich mehr so ein Dropout geworden.
Well, we're like using our Twitter account, for instance, as just a proclaiming organ, just to post our own messages, and obviously also Diaspora also.
Weiterleiten automatisiert von
But this is just an automated service where we just republish our releases.
Wir haben trotzdem jetzt mal einfach, weil natürlich die Anzahl derjenigen, die uns auf Twitter folgt, schon deutlich höher ist als bei Diaspora oder
So yeah, obviously the followers on Twitter is these are the largest number of followers, like compared to Diaspora. So we do use this and republish on other channels. So it is actually the Twitter channel that gets the most attention. And I'd like to highlight a few of these points. Well, one highlight was obviously the German government trying to purchase zero-day exploits and the way we treated this. Another was the support for Edward Snowden and an honorary membership for him. A whole other debate about a court case that the CCC filed. We're going to discuss this later on. So here you can see like a comparison between German and English tweets. Some topics obviously have a bigger scale and a larger international international interest so that it's more, yeah, that we try and get it in several languages. And well, the email, this was a German government trying to develop a end-to-end encrypted, or not even end-to-end encrypted email service. It was quite a joke, and we've been accompanying this critically. And yeah, well, you can always pull a email joke. These were obviously popular tweets. So first it was a paid service, then they changed it to free, and now you maybe get a free voucher for your whatever. First they came for the porn. This refers to the info we got that these blacklists or censorship lists could be well, this was like our highlight tweet, 420 retweets. But we're gonna mention these censorship structures more seriously later on. So.
So this tweet shows it was almost a winner. We put out like a complaint with a general attorney about buying. We'll try new things all the time with various media and trying new things, new corporations with international media, and this hopefully continues in 2015 with new developments. So sometimes there are long-term developments, and so we have some time to plan, and some time it's hopefully will continue in 2015. So now we start at the beginning, and we start at January. It was a very cold month. 16 million email addresses were stolen. BSI, the German Ministry for Information Security, put up a page where you could enter your email address to figure out if your email was compromised or your password. Three internet ministers were presented to us before we even didn't have anyone, and now we have three. Sigmar Gabriel, like Ministry for Economics, Alexander Dobrindt, Minister for Information Highway. And the third one, who was that? De Maizière. He isn't allowed to go missing. Net neutrality order by the FCC was turned over, and Andrea Vosshoff was data protection officer in the German government. But no valuable input from her so far. Maybe you should say something to that. Peter Schaar, her predecessor, spoke here last year, and he was given a hearty farewell. And even now we only realize what a good job he did.
The
other question you have to ask yourself is who is guilty, why this post was so declining in value, let's say. And it seems that this position lastingly dropped in value or in importance.
Aber selbstverständlich haben die mitregierenden Sozialdemokraten sie auch mitgewählt.
And also the also governing Social Democrats elected her as well, so they are also at fault and not only the Christian Democrats.
Beide Regierungsparteien sehr deutlich gemacht haben, inwieweit ihnen.
And both governing parties made clear. How important that post is for them, which is like not at all. The office of the Federal Privacy Protection Officer is
now
was asked to become an independent office, but so it's independent now, but it's still controlled by the government, so it's actually not that independent.
Sein wird, sich sozusagen muss ich ins Einvernehmen und Benehmen setzen mit dem Kanzleramt, wenn etwa.
Yeah, and now the holder of that post actually always has to confirm with the Chancellor's office what they're actually doing, and so it should be more independent, but well, in practice that's apparently not the case.
Okay, also ich glaube zu Frau Vossoff braucht man nicht viel weiter sagen.
So I don't think we have to say much more to Ms. Vossoff.
Sie hat ja keine Vorschusslorbeeren bekommen. Ihr habt das vielleicht alle gelesen.
She didn't get any bonus points in advance.
Es war klar, dass sie keine Kompetenzen in dem Feld hat. Sie hat sich als
she has no competences in this area. As a MDP, she always positioned against data protection. So yeah, she met the expectations.
Zu dem Verfahren vor dem Europäischen Gerichtshof ist nicht wirklich eine Aktion des CCC.
So a small update to the procedure before the European Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg. It's not directly an action by the CCC, but Constance is involved with it, and we get help, of course, by the CCC. So we got notice that we got a Rule 41 priority case, which means that it's going to be processed faster. And during the year, some changes happened, but we didn't make a press release for that on CCC.de.
Kein neuerliches Ergebnis dabei war.
Because like actually no new result was decided.
Also nicht formalen, sondern inhaltlichen Fragenkatalog erstellt und an die britische Regierung.
So the court put out a new catalog of questions.
Die Open Rights Group und Big Brother Watch natürlich.
And several NGOs.
Die Beschwerdeführer, die vertreten sind.
The main
die Bundesregierung hat sich entschieden, darauf keine Antwort zu geben.
Dennoch and yeah, there was some issues because Constanze is German national and the main complainants are British nationals.
Nun ja, jetzt auch nicht so überraschend. Interessant ist noch, dass
so another interesting thing is that there's more procedures by British activists.
Investigatory Powers Tribunal, IPT.
Before the Investigative Powers Tribunal in Great Britain, which is like a secret court. And so it's not really sure in this case if we can go to Strasbourg directly or. But then it turned out that there was another court case where they already decided, so there's at least a few others who can go directly to Strasbourg. And so that the Brits actually signed the European Declaration of Human Rights, so they're actually bound to that and have to allow cases going to Strasbourg. So there's communication between lawyers and the court, and there were some
doch noch gewartet wurde, hat aber nichts an dem Start.
There were some slowdowns, but still, yeah, the case is going on, and maybe probably in spring we can give you some new
priority by priority case,
some new developments, some new updates.
Weil das ist Januar. bald ein Jahr wieder her.
How much priority is actually priority?
So einer Anhörung oder weiteren Schritten kommen. Aber im Sommer hatte sich das Gericht entschieden zu warten auf die Fälle, die in Großbritannien anliegen beim IPT.
So actually the court decided to wait for the other cases from Great Britain because they are similar in content.
Schon im Vormonat ist der Chaos Computer Club Dresden umgezogen. Das war
so Chaos Computer Club Dresden moved to new home.
Das HQ umbenannt in
and they,
Chaos Headquarters GC.
They renamed the HQ to Grand Chaos HQ. GCHQ.
Was auch eine sehr schöne postalische Adresse jetzt ergibt.
Very nice postal address they have now.
Postläufern jetzt vorbeikommt.
Maybe they'll get some random mailings now.
Damit sind wir dann schon im Februar angekommen.
Now it's February already. Very cold month. Publishers banded together in VG Media.
Nachdem Comcast
Netflix made a deal with Comcast. And yeah, after Net Neutrality was disbanded in the USA. Christoph Käse, German lobbyist, is for the publishers law. Was actually quite happy, but CCC actually first just filed a complaint against the government.
Der Strafanzeige, wenn wir gar nicht so sehr viel sagen. Also ich meine, da ist viel schon gesagt worden. Ich würde eigentlich gerne ein bisschen was
so much has been said about the about the complaint, but we're told that it's a very political move and not more, but
hingedeutet haben, dass die Öffentlichkeit quasi gewartet hat, dass irgendwie auch mein Schritt
apparently the
juristischen Behörden gemacht wird.
The public was waiting for actually someone doing a step to the in theory responsible government authorities.
Natürlich nicht nur. Denn man muss
so it's of course a political action, but not only.
Zumindest auch irgendwann, selbst wenn es sehr lange dauern wird, bis der Generalbundesanwalt
at some point, even if it takes very long, at least they will have to decide either they drop the case or they don't or they prosecute in some way. But of course that's kind of unlikely as he's not even allowed to read the case files.
Danach im Wege zu sagen, des Einlegens von
but of course then you can still file a complaint against in the court or something like that, so it's still there's still possibilities, but of course it takes time.
Liga für Menschenrechte haben natürlich auch den
lawyers of the International League for Human Rights helped write the complaint against the government.
Der Snowden-Papiere kamen, die haben wir dann allerdings tatsächlich selbst geschrieben.
And dann what was put forth by the Snowden papers, we helped put that in and then the lawyers added their legal part.
Also, ja.
Yeah, we so we would like interaction actually, you know. In every interview, we had to justify that it was a political action, but I'm still convinced that our criminal law is still prohibiting intelligence agency actions, so it should still be complied with.
And I still don't see a point that you can also start such a criminal case for political reasons. I think that's legitimate. We'll come back to that later. There was an amendment regarding CCC, but this is just about the criminal case right now. Then there was a consultation of the Federal Network Agency about the IT security catalog, in which they were discussing the rules and regulations for the providers of critical infrastructure. Matthias Dahlheimer of Concourse Computer Club wrote a statement about that. We criticize that the providers are allowed to define their own security standards and their compliances. Also by the network agency.
So a
couple of weeks later, we saw this in the IT security law, not just for network providers, but also for providers of critical infrastructure. And in the IT security law, so it's the case that they don't want that every single provider can set their own security standards, but the idea is that within your the business associations, people come up with security standards together.
Und dann darüber entschieden wird.
Debate these standards, and then it will be decided by the federal agency whether their proposal is correct or should be extended. So the federal agency apparently does not think it can set these standards itself, but thinks this should be done by the Association of Network Providers.
Minimal baseline security standards mit.
All of these bring 200 to 300 pages of minimum security standards and then find the smallest common denominator.
Man kann sich also überlegen, welche der beiden Optionen ein
or that you put all requirements together, and this is a lot of work, so of course you can, it's very apparent that they will choose the smallest common denominator. So we don't think that there will be an increase of security overall. When it comes to the increase of security,
wir mussten,
we in 2003 we had to react to internet blocking in North Rhine-Westphalia.
Filtern von DNS.
They wanted to filter DNS requests, and in that context we pointed out that you have to inquire who you trust your DNS requests to, and we established resolvers who you can talk to and inquire if you don't trust your ISP.
So
it's an alternative source
und diese IP-Adresse erreichbar
to
ist.
Your ISP to inquire whether you're reaching the right DNS server. A year later, there was a problem. The people who ask us received wrong answers. And that was why in one of these open resolvers, we didn't eliminate a security risk on time. And that was we're very embarrassed by this. So we used there was a software from EGB, and we replaced this by a modern extension, and now this is working fine again.
Yeah.
Thank you. In this context, this service has been run by volunteers, and I wouldn't criticize them for that. They, over the years,
diverse andere Probleme, die Betriebssysteme
they solved a lot of other problems in the operating system, for instance. So we don't just run open resolvers, but also, since a really long time, Tor infrastructure, YAC infrastructure. We have a huge Java server since a couple of years, has been growing. We have a couple of Java services which are all growing, and there's a very fundamental problem. If there's a centralization in such an institution you trust, as always, there's the Microsoft problem. If everybody uses a monoculture, there's a single point of failure, a very juicy target. So if the secret services of the world are interested in our Java server and want to inquire our Java server, we do not reach our intended goal, which is so in addition to thanking our volunteers, I would like to ask all of you for decentralization. Everybody should run their own Java servers. You should establish Tor exit points and be very careful in doing that. There are rules and there are instructions on how to do that securely according to German law. How to get in touch with your ISP and tell them that you're establishing a reverse entry so that law enforcement knows that you're running an exit point. So this is a possibility, and we as the Chaos Computer Club, we don't want that everybody donates money to us just that so that we run these services, because also services like Tor rely on the fact that there's not a single player which is so big that it's so visible and dominant in the network that it becomes insecure. So we love your donations and money, but it's still important that everybody who wants to support us also supports us in action by growing and diversifying our infrastructure. I also think redundancy establishes security, and we have to ask everyone to build their own infrastructures. So this problem with centralization has become very evident in a couple of days ago when Jabber CCC received 1 or 2 gigabyte data and was offline for 1 or 2 days. And then we only realized how many people are dependent on that. So it's good if you have an account, but you need other accounts, preferably on servers run by friends, organizations you trust.
Wir haben uns noch aus dem Bereich Infrastruktur auch noch an Freifunk beteiligt.
In the field of infrastructure, we also participate in Freifunk concerning decentralized infrastructures. You probably know this.
Internet zu bringen.
They bring villages and small towns online in a decentralized way. So who wants to talk about this, about the support of that? Regarding Freifunk, we have like in a lot of our local constituencies, we have a lot of active members, and we try to centralize that or coordinate that, but the structure has been growing organically over the past years. So we always call for decentralization, but our new thing is forced decentralization. Because like since fabrication yesterday, you can't register for Jabber at the moment. So at this point in time, you have to decentralize. That's another level of escalation. So we'll see how to continue that next year. The question is like how does the club define itself or see its role in that? We see a growing attitude that like the club can run this, you can establish these infrastructures, but in the end it's a couple of individuals who are interested in volunteering, but we as a structure are not that good in doing this. It's individuals who spend time and energy, and it's dependent on their work, and you have to rely on them to provide you infrastructure and running it professionally. So it's not our job to run infrastructure. We love doing this, but this is not our main purpose.
Ähnliches würde natürlich gelten. Also ich meine, wenn man schon am Jabber-Server aufsetzen ist, kann man auch gleich noch einen Port machen.
And of course this applies to if you run a Jabber-Server, you can run a Diaspora pod as well. So this concerns social media in the same way. So if you think about the email addresses, you can also set up a mail server. All these things are good contributions. So help friends.
And then there's the next month. Something really interesting happened. Mark Zuckerberg, who was always in the CC Breakview, complained himself at Barack Obama about how the NSA spied on everybody else. So somebody new who wants to work with us. Well, more or less. The European data safety went into the parliament, but nothing happened there. The European court case allowed these internet blockings, and an NSA group was called into the name. Was called into action. At the beginning, they only looked at the NASA, but it's under the order of Clemens Binninger, who was not that, well, no. Meninger, maybe somebody remembers him. Well, if you've been in the canteen of the Bundestag, you know him. But the interesting effect is that he was decided to be the head, but he ran away. So we'll get to that on April. We also
Free Software Foundation
communicated with the Free Software Foundation towards the Bundesnetzagentur, who said that that everybody can provide their own router, and we are still on the opinion that that's true, and we still think that the Bundesnetzagentur should also make sure that that's known. Especially when you change the provider, if the device is directly connected to the network, then it's an attack point, and you want to have your own decision to run free software, which is usually not on the router. So the critic points are still there, but we just pointed at the Bundesnetzagentur that we do care about this subject, that we look at how the rules change in the future. The Bundesnetzagentur, after this formal of the situation, we didn't get a response for that, changed their propositions in some points towards our direction, also if the equalization the forced router change was announced, but there were no real success. What's quite interesting on this point is that how the provider argument, so what they actually want is that they force their customers to use one specific device to get internet at home or to use their internet connection, and they force them by trying to lock the device for the users so they don't have the knowledge on how to configure another router to use DSL. They say that the modem is an important part of the internet connection that, if working wrong, could lead to problems on the network. So we had that already? That reminds me of the Bundespost, also the German telecom. So the debate is, where does the the telephone network finish? And so the router and the wireless access point is just one device. The end of the connection is at our wireless, not in front of the modem or at our modem. So the technical discussion had its high point this year, so that the Bundesnetzagentur moved the decision up until the there was a law, so that they had actually the need or the permission to do something like that. So they're at the moment just afraid to do anything. I can just assume why it's that way. Yes, well, we know that the Bundesnetzagentur is a bit slow in many places. But I think that there's also a political discussion room. So the coalition was against that. So we want to make sure that there are no backdoors in the agreements when our work together with the Free Software Foundation. Constanze. Ah, yeah. There was, I want to mention it because there are a lot of press requests about that, and because nothing happened to someone from the press team in the last year. So I was first invited because of a 31st C3 hack, which happened anonymous.
It was
about a romantic addressed mails which were sent to many members of the high school Karlsruhe who called, which were not pornographic. And month after the Congress, in April, I wanted to talk there at the Karlsruhe about Snowden, and I was abroad, and suddenly I read a letter to me on the internet, and it was this one, and I hadn't received it yet. They sent it to my office, and I didn't get it yet. So it was quite interesting to get my letters over the internet. So I don't know why they decided to put it into the internet, but they did not think it was adequate to invite me here, because someone had sent these love mails, this gay love mail. So some people had responded to these love emails. So apparently there were quite a few embarrassing moments. Funnily, there was quite a bit of Barbara Streisand. Someone at the took the ad and wrote it into the blog, and much later, after it was completely forgotten, there were TV teams there and who asked questions about love emails. So it's quite funny. There are long blog posts where these emails are written in the internet. So next to the they finally added SMTP authentication. You have to say a bit more about that. Check your university networks, where the University of Karlsruhe is a quite surprise, because just they were forced to look at it. They're completely different school. It's like that. So they just completely stopped the organization. So everybody was of a different opinion than the leader of the school. So yeah, I did not go there, and someone was here is fault of that. So we don't think that it's important to talk here about it, but that's some of the work we do if you represent this club. The club went behind the doors after Constanze was disinvited. We invited the CCC, went to Hochspeyer, nearly in South France, in a future planning sessions. It is a youth hostel, so please look at the double bed. Because some people from the East Republic, who were never outside of Berlin, with the decision that it was in France, we tunneled all the domain name requests through the French network. So we sat together for a week, and we talked about what we want to do with this club. We made a lot of actions over the last years, but we never talked with each other about what we wanted to do. So we locked ourselves in for a weekend, and we had great weather, and we had a great wine and talked really good. Okay. Everybody screamed at each other, and we discussed a lot. And it wasn't just happy. So we have the problem that the CCC grew significantly. Not the number of actives grew significantly, but that led to a problem that you can't discuss internally. So if you know a discussion that we have to talk about, because it will happen next year, so we talked about here things for the first time, and it really was a youth hostel. So it was also to find an opinion and find people who wanted to engage in that. But the wine was well. Hagpiet can talk more about that. So what I was part of was Karls macht Schule, so Karls goes to school. It's a quite active group in the CCC, and it was here. They were here. So please a warm round of applause that they were here. Yes, well, so that everything happens as well with these small groups of Chaos Macht Schule, which are decentralized, we have to meet centralized twice a year, once in spring, in the west of Germany, which was the south, and in October, more northly. So we decide to these two meetings to also work on our. And we also want to invite other people who wanted to make projects like these, just to share our own and give, pass on knowledge. So, April. April was a funny month. The EU Parliament decided for net neutrality and against roaming fees. The US government decided that maybe they should remove the NSA to, well, to downgrade them. There was great applause for that, but email made in Germany switched on TLS after a long time. Finally, the European law decided that the preemptuous saving of telephone information was unlawful, and so thank you for those who worked towards that. The had to talk about it. Then there was something about Heartbleed. Yesterday we had a nice explanation about what happened, and Kevin Zwinginger stepped back because Snowden was supposed to be invited into the NSA security, and they. That was not the official decision, but because he claimed that he had a problem of interest because he was in two gremiums who talk about that, but he noticed that after 2 months. We don't know exactly why, but Professor Dr. Prentice is the new head of the NSA security. And it was never really an NSA. It's actually mostly about Secret Service or the BND. If you read what's about, there are three parts. For once, of course, parts about the NSA or the GCHQ, but on the other part of the German Secret Services, and also that they are supposed to find some answers for which we wait. The club has done.
So, we had a small incident in Stuttgart, Baden-Württemberg. There's a day before Easter. And we had a location for our local event, which was supposed to like sell beer and etc. But public holidays.
War auch sehr super. Stuttgart war ein klasse Gastgeber. Ich glaube auch da mal einen warmen Applaus dafür.
That was a great host for us. So.
Natürlich auch für die Auf- und Abbau.
Keep calm and Comic Song. We had a lot of hot dogs in Stuttgart. And obviously the police arrived when we were clearing out to see if we had left it behind in a state.
Eingehalten werden und dann natürlich eine Veranstaltung vom CCC.
That was acceptable. This is the south of Germany. They have the Kehrwoche, which is like cleaning your house, and they take this very seriously. So.
Genau. Es gibt andere schöne Veranstaltungen.
So we complied with the Kehrwoche. So this is a completely different event. It's called Barbecue without any necessity. So we just have, you know, for no reason at all, fresh air, sausages, and
extrem
on the fire.
Aber nichts, was man mit, vielleicht mit Würstchen und alkoholischen Getränken vielleicht irgendwie
so we were bitten to bits by bomb mosquitoes, but these were quite a lot of the alphas, the regional working circles collaborating here, and we're going to do that again next year, the barbecue for no reason. Maybe Cologne. Are you sure? Well, all the like West German Alpha circles.
So, another
highlight is the Big Brother Award, Edward Snowden, and the German Chancellor's office was also one of the awardees of this. Well, negative prize, but in fact, Snowden was our first like positive prize.
Also wenn sie in Deutschland, dann liefern sie nicht mehr.
And also a bus service and CSC. You can look at the awardees of the awards on the Big Brother website. And we can see that we weren't obviously anyone awarding something to Snowden. So especially German groups or lobby groups, activists. There's been a lot of ceremonies and prizes. It's hard to count. It's just at least 24, but in Germany in particular, which I find remarkable.
Nicht zu vergessen, es handelt sich hier um die deutschen Big Brother Awards, die von der Digital Courage vergeben werden.
So these are the German Big Brother Awards. They're awarded by Digital Courage vom Föbot.
Hatte eine relativ hohe Medienaufmerksamkeit.
But like even in the Netherlands we get quite a lot of media attention. So we're forking.
Unterschiedliche Zeitpunkte natürlich.
But in the Netherlands, like the awards will be at a different time. So now, May.
Die Bundesregierung Snowden nicht für den NSA, für den BND-Untersuchungsausschuss einladen möchte.
So this was the first statement from the German government that they don't want to invite Edward Snowden to the Secret Service or the NSA government inquiry in German Parliament. Well, it would have been like the more decent move to enable this invitation, and
unter ihrem neuen Chef Wheeler bekannt oder bequem gemacht. Das ist ein ehemaliger Lobbyist, der
well, Wheeler is a former lobbyist of cable network services and the European Court. We're going to talk about that later. The right to forget. This was a big debate, but
nicht ermitteln zu wollen, hauptsächlich um niemandem auf die Füße zu treten.
So the reason to not like press this inquiry further within the NSA Inquiry Commission was just to not offend anyone. It was a policy question more than anything else, so they were being very, very cautious.
Mannheim ist eine Stadt in Baden-Württemberg.
So, Mannheim, which is a city in the south of Germany, Baden-Württemberg, it's quite a nice place. Well, yeah, you managed to leave Berlin, that's commendable. CCC travels.
So, Diskussionen und fröhlichen Entscheidungen.
What happened there was like a meetup. We have a new head of CCC. That's Dodger, who you can occasionally see walking around here, and you can give him a big hand now.
Wir haben zwei neue zweite Vorsitzende, Andreas Burg und
and, the deputies are Andreas Burg and Martin Hasemacher.
Wir haben den neuen Schatzmeister Dominik Keller.
Dominik Keller for finance, which you need as a German club, you need a certain
Repräsentanten Hackbeat.
And for ERFA, for the regional circuits, the CEO of the Heart is
wurden auch einige Entscheidung getroffen, die wir dann auch fröhlich bekannt gegeben haben.
Da kommen wir gleich zu.
And we had another quite a round of happy decision making.
Man muss konstatieren, das ist ja jetzt ein paar Monate her.
It's quite good to discuss
the
collaboration
und dem Vorstand
within different groups, like the CCC management as well as the press representatives, spokespeople, and even Heckbeat can be integrated into the discussion. So communication does help to just find a level of exchange.
Des Antragens der Ehrenmitgliedschaft, was wir dann auch unmittelbar nach der Mitgliederversammlung gemacht haben, zog sich aber hin, aber
after our members meet up, this was just consensus that we want to support Edward Snowden and also offer this honorary membership.
Also gleich nochmal drauf, dass wir es geschafft haben.
So this was quite a sort of GDR style result in the election, so there was not a lot of opposition. I think that was more or less consensus, and the growth that we're seeing here, I think it's good to see that we can find common ground.
EuGH-Urteil zum Recht auf Vergessen. Und da haben wir natürlich auch relativ viele Fragen zu bekommen.
So the European Court decision about the so-called right to forget, suppressing search engine results that are outdated or unwanted. This was one of the big topics. Well, first of all, we didn't really push our opinions or articulate too much what we thought of that, because we didn't really have how to position ourselves in that content.
Suchmaschinen angeht. Zum anderen wird aber, wie sich hinterher jetzt zeigt, natürlich dieses Urteil in großem Maße genutzt von Leuten.
So this judgment is used in a very big way by people who did something not morally great, but then want to cover that up in some way. And like, for example, kick out press releases or press articles out of Google. And so that's like a dilemma. So it's, you know, in a way it's for privacy, but also not really.
An der Stelle nicht wirklich inhaltlich was
beitragen. We can't really add anything meaningful to a discussion there, I think.
Als ich dann raus war, also die Berichterstattung hat sich leider nur fast nur auf die Pressemitteilung des EuGHs bezogen, aber
the most news articles were just about the press release, but after the judgment was properly released, we actually looked at the judgment in full and well, of course, it was very hard to argue, because, you know, then there's like a lot of debate how many actually complaints or notices were actually given to Google, and so, but, you know, you couldn't check that in any way, and so that's part of the problem, that the issue was never that the information was incorrect, but that you don't want it to be found, and so that's kind of a tricky issue, and that's one of the problems that by having like one very dominant search engine in the European area. They have a very interesting style of argumentation based on privacy law, because they said search engine is not a search engine, but an aggregation of data over a search term, like an automated aggregation of data. And that means that the search engine is has to comply with privacy law, as it's aggregating data about a person or data over a person, because it's showing relevant information to a certain term.
Der kuriose Fall, dass dieses Suchergebnis ja nicht verschwindet. Es verschwindet nur,
and
wenn man genau nach
so,
und daher auch der
kuriose so that, Fall, dass that's why the search result doesn't disappear just if you exactly search for a specific name. And the original article, of course, stays there because and it's not deleted because it's protected by freedom of the press. But the search engine results or the searching for results is not. You know, Google has like this committee that they set up, who should decide, who is deciding, which results gets deleted and which don't. So it's like an extra judicial body that is set up by a private entity. Yeah, it's not really necessarily a positive. Positive development, but it's like really hard to. It's really hard to say if that's really positive or negative development, and hard to know what is the majority opinion of club members. And it's like a base conflict in the hacker ethics. Like how open or free are data supposed to be, and how does that interact with like personal data integrity? And yeah, so we should have a look at how that gets developed in the next years, how people will use it, and how many results will get deleted. But of course, the judgment wouldn't have been possible if Google wouldn't be so dominant. And I think we should keep a look on that as.
Ob das eher in Richtung Zensur geht,
yeah, if it's going towards censorship or
wir wegen da
or if we trying to like find a proper balance
der Menge der Anfragen, die Google behauptet,
but because of the width of information that they get, it looks much more like censorship, I think. We have to hurry up, we don't have that much time, or we could talk for it about ages.
Das kommt gleich.
What for ages?
Das ist das schöne Foto.
It is a nice picture now. I had the pleasure to do something constructive in a commission of the German Parliament.
Ein wunderschönes Erlebnis, dass ich hier.
I had a great experience.
Okay, ich erzähle erstmal, wo ich war. Ich war im Bundestag.
I was in the Parliament for. Commission for a Digital Agenda, and I was supposed to present about IT security in the era post-Snowden. What can politics do to increase IT security? So that's a nice topic or a nice question, because the insecurities are at a different layer than politics are, than at the layer which politics happens. So you really have to think about what actually want to say, or what politics can actually do there.
And
so in the discussions, and so we came up with proposing bug bounties from the government, or how is it possible that software developers don't have to take on any damages claims and can just put bugs on the consumers or users and don't have to accept any responsibility? And
weil ich natürlich sagen würde, dass natürlich ein Softwarehersteller nicht automatisch für jeden Bug in der Software haften kann, aber
of course no software developer can automatically be held liable for every bug, but you know, still in like very
Computerhersteller, also fahrende Computerautos unterhält, dann merkt man, wie widersprüchlich da diese Szene
like ist. If you're talking to a,
das ist ja häufig heute auch schon wegen der
Elektronik. If you're talking to a car manufacturer, which is like basically a car with a computer, you actually see the differences because they have like a whole big,
ganz klar,
there's a world of difference as they have like callback actions for like returning cars if there's a problem.
Haftungsprobleme, was noch so interessanten.
So you really try to somehow to licensing and whatever, try to minimize liability. Decentralization, but it's not really new. Something new, but it's still important.
Den Frank da geprägt hat.
And so Frank put out this word of evidence-based security laws. So if you do something, that wants to do surveillance or security, then we really want to make sure that you actually base this on evidence and not just, like for example with data retention, when you're not really, it's not really possible to prove that it actually works or does anything useful, then please should we just revert this rights violation.
Die mir an der Stelle wichtig war und die
another important request that because someone from BSI, Federal Office for Security of Information, and somebody was there.
Das Innenministerium hat ja als
the Ministry of the Interior as,
nicht unbedingt so ein Interesse daran, dass
as responsible for police, intelligence agencies, and so on, you know, and they are responsible for security of information.
So the question is, if you're doing it the same way with the data protection agency, whether it's in accordance with the office of the chancellor. So it depends on the details if you find such a solution, but we're not going to be tired of repeating that demand. What I find really interesting and the reason why I find this is a very constructive contribution, my biggest fan in this assembly wasn't the Green Party, the ones who invited me, but I'm going to show you a picture now. A representative of the Christian Democratic Party, Christian Tom Sombeck, and who appreciated my calls for security and
im Ausschuss saß und
smiled at me
habe.
While I was wearing my suit.
So,
the hacker next to him, he's also close to the CCC. So, but he wasn't invited on our behalf.
Ja, so viel also zum Ausschuss.
Warte mal. Jetzt sag aber noch mal zu diesem Ausschuss. Was
you have to say something about this.
Jetzt musst du schon mal offenlegen.
Das weiß
about
ich nicht.
This assembly and what they're doing there. I actually don't know. It's called Assembly for a Digital Agenda. So it happened after the Enquete Commission, in the last election period, and everybody said we need an assembly for internet topics, but it has no legislative power. So you can debate and discuss very openly, but laws are made somewhere elsewhere. So that's the Assembly for Digital Agenda. And it's not closely related to the Digital Agenda directly. Oh, so you mean it's not the paper Digital Agenda? Yes, exactly. But you do recognize fragments from the paper Digital Agenda in the Assembly Digital Agenda. Excuse me?
Is it okay?
So we would like to say a couple of sentences to the CCC Switzerland. So a couple of days ago, they turned 2 years old, where the people in Switzerland came together to found CCC Switzerland. This is Zurich, Basel, Bern, St. Gallen, So there are small chaos meetups, and especially the club in Zurich was very active. There's also a problem in Switzerland with BIP, the question of the surveillance of, I think it's called postal transportation, but also the Swiss Secret Service. They organized something called Million March, which I thought was a very nice name, and they have regular meetings. They have a chaos meetup with the University of Zurich, so they really developed their own activities and in Switzerland. And that's a good thing. 2015, and CCC Switzerland contributed to that. There's also a Digital Society Association in Switzerland. In 2015, there will be a ruling on preemptive saving of data, and we should really keep that in mind.
Wir haben jetzt die Schweiz gelobt.
Data retention is the correct name.
Es folgte der Monat Juni.
So the next month is June. This year we celebrated a year of Snowden. Well, not really celebrated, but the principal state lawyer, decided that he wants to investigate the surveillance of Angela Merkel's phone, and incidentally not the surveillance of people, but Merkel's phone. The European Union declared that they're not going to have another initiative on data retention. So, but we shouldn't be too happy. This is not settled yet. BitLocker was recommended. VG Media sued Google for so-called Leistungsschutzgeld, so money for their services. And Snowden canceled his appearance in the investigation of the NSA files because he wasn't allowed to enter the country. Cecilia Malmström, the EU commissioner, declared that she will do another proposal for data retention because the election period is almost over. So yes, after the election, she'll be the commissioner for trade. And the CCC Berlin extended their toolbox. What's that? So this is a picture of a electronic microscope, a very specific one. And so the Chaos Computer Club is not what we see here, but it's an assembly of decentralized clubs who do really cool work on the ground. And we hope that they feel represented in that what we're doing here and what we're talking about here. But they do need tools to do cool things.
Es im CCC diese Dezentralisierung gibt und
and since we have decentralization here at the club, our members are very critical what happens to the money. So in our members' assembly at the beginning of the year,
coole Projektanträge hat, der soll mal
everybody who has ideas for cool projects should face less bureaucracy, and we're going to give a basic equipment for tools in the local clubs to hack. A lot of local clubs have done this, they wrote a wish list, and in this context, amazing things happened, like this electronic microscope in Berlin. That's not really a basic equipment. Can I also use it? Yes, you may. Starbuck took this picture, and he probably will be very pleased to give you an introduction. But I think this is a great development. And that's another reason to go to your local club.
Spielzeug sehen wollt,
and
weil
just ask what kind of tools you want, because we think membership fees are, that's exactly what membership fees are for. They enable work in your club to buy tools, to buy educational tools, and to create them.
Und
so in the context of our future days and internal discussions.
Hat sich so ein Konsens herausgebildet, dass wir
we build a consensus
einen Werkzeug
majority opinion on the fact that we need a tool to show majority opinions in our club. So one member of the club, Marcel, he started the initiative and started Liquid Feedback. It's called Cord, as you can see in the URL. HTTPS, an onion address, client serves.
So als verspielter Nerd auch
eat this, Piraten.
So that's a good example of how to do this as a nerd, as a good nerd and cool hacker. So in this liquid, we discussed a lot of initiatives. All those we agreed on have been implemented. Sadly, activity decreased a little bit in June. But I think it's pretty cool that somebody did such a thing and it has been used. So thank you to Marcel for starting this project.
Der Chaospot in Essen
Chaospot in Essen
auf 130 Quadratmeter has its
extended its club space of another 100 square meters. And every 8 weeks they do a crypto party, so they have a very active club life and they have really pretty websites which they take care of and maintain.
Bundes-CCC, dass da so rege Aktivität stattfindet.
Da haben wir ein Projekt für 2015.
So that would be a project for 2015. I'm going to leak this. We're building our website and we already have volunteers. So I don't know if it will be as lovely as last time, but it's going to happen.
So not only nice rooms we have, but also many nice small things. This is a simple image from the Gulasch programming night from the Erfurt Karlsruhe. Well, the name is, well, it's a Gulasch programming night. There is a lot of Gulasch which was sold out relatively early, both the meat variant and the non-meat variant, which was cooked by its own helpers and members, and in fact that happens. There was an ice machine because there was nice weather, and after 18 liters of production, the ice machine overheated. So I have no idea why it's an ice machine when it overheats. Apparently it's an undocumented feature, which that piece appears not to do in long term. I don't know whether there was goulash ice, but next year there's supposed to be goulash ice cream. Yeah, there are photos from goulash ice cream. So, it's interesting that the ice machine overheated when we do goulash ice. So, next year it's again this thing in Karlsruhe, so please come everybody. So, we did not forget that this year. In July, Facebook started its experiment.
Die Realität so abgebildet
so that Facebook did not really show everything as we expected it. And there was a fair use drossel for too much network. There was an NSA spy in the BND and which was found, and there was a Great Britain surveillance over emergency act was got back for emergency act, and Plagiator used the copyright to protect against somebody looking about his whether he may have copied something.
Urheberrechtsgesetz eine Veröffentlichung zu verhindern.
There is a case of law against the government who wanted to use copyright against publishing something. Freifunk wants to work against the Störerhaftung, that if you provide a wireless network, you're liable for what is done over there. Someone from Germany recommended to Edward Snowden to go back into the USA, and Frank was sued. So if Frank wears a suit, he always explains something in the Secret Service Untersuchungsausschuss.
Na, damals hieß er noch NSA, da waren wir noch.
So back then it was the NSA, Untersuchungsausschuss, not the Secret Service. So it was, I was invited relatively spontane, so with 2 days head up, because another from Canada decided not to come. And it was quite strange, because the MPs were quite happy to have people who could reasonably well explain them what that all was about. So it was still the phase where. So maybe you have to add, it's the second questioning. The one before was only from lawyers, and that was the first time they actually talked about technology. And interesting about it was, for me, especially about the usual procedure,
how much it was used
to try to figure out as little as possible.
Fragen halt immer möglichst weggehen von Themen, die halt irgendwie problematisch sein können.
To go away from questions which are problematic.
Herrn Kiesewetter.
And if you look at the second,
damals irgendwie
the vice president,
die Nachfolge von Binninger antreten sollen und nicht.
He was supposed to go to be the one after Binninger. So whenever something was critical, became critical, his face changed. The questions which were asked were usually just about, how does it use work? Which technological requirements are there? What is in the documents that were known to that day? There was a lot of press about that. Also afterwards, the press asked many questions. And sometimes from our MPs who just wanted to understand. Problematic is there's the question about what they ask for. It's a general problem.
Im Wissen, dass sie halt dann durch diese parlamentarische Maschine mutiert werden und man sie hinterher möglicherweise nicht wieder.
So which questions do you propose that they work through this and but they are mutilated and in the end you can't understand them and they're a complete different question. You have to be make sure that you ask questions or request information that is clear. So we have to care for two things. We have to, first of all, put the public in that, and Netzpolitik does a great job because they live block, so they block these events. And on the other hand, it's also our job to bring the public to pay attention to that. And towards the end, it changed a bit. The person from the CDU already sees the solution for this. So he went into the NSA problem mode delta, and he asked someone who he invited over Twitter.
Beschuldigt, er würde fantasieren, denn die Staatsrechte haben da alle drei. Also
he said he was just having strange ideas, and when they talked about how wrong the BND worked for the German
Grundgesetz. Sie hat sich ja eigentlich hier ja nicht. Also das ist ja eher für die.
So when he goes there and says, hey, that's for the conspiracy theorists. And interestingly, in the beginning, everybody wanted to know what really happens. So we have to keep up with that.
So I want to say something else. We do have to hurry up a little bit, but two of the court cases that the CCC was involved in, I'd like to mention. So we were working with quite a number of ISPs and organizations. So we had the situation this British Court.
So initiiert wurde, ob es wohl so klappen wird, dass wir sozusagen als eine deutsche Organisation Infrastruktur anbietet.
If we as a German organization can provide the infrastructure, we didn't know yet. But the specific point that was highlighted here didn't relate to surveillance, but to the interception tools themselves. So this, we just tried to highlight the fact that critical infrastructure damage is just the side effect, basically, of this. So, and only a couple of days later, we extended the court case that we'd already submitted early in the year regarding so-called filtering lists or
explizit die Tor Server von einem Studenten hier in Deutschland betrafen.
As soon as we'd found out we had a concrete case that Tor servers
die Strafanzeige bezieht sich nur darauf, dass wir fordern, dass der was ermittelt, was seine verdammte Aufgabe wäre. Und deshalb haben wir da so, was haben wir geschrieben? Ich würde mal sagen, 20, 25 Seiten nochmal nachgelegt.
And so we extended the original complaint to the federal prosecutor. So this is all public and tried to just integrate these new facts. And this was maybe a good opportunity to submit in very plain words and very simple terms to the prosecution what was actually the problem. So this Tor incident gave us another opportunity to extend or explain that a bit further. But these are still running procedures.
So we
have a lot more activity, like on a legal level that we're used to, or that we're accustomed to, or at least this year it was particularly notable. So we do have more than two lawyers or jurists with these specialties, and some of them are even programmers as well. But this is an area. It's getting more important, but still we have to see. I mean, how much does that really help? So how much do we want to really get involved in this sort of legal and jurisdiction procedures? Is it worthwhile? And I think just our attitude there is to do as much as necessary, but not. Well, not to put too much work into that, because there's a lot of interaction on this legal level. This is quite difficult. I mean, especially seeing that the legal system isn't exactly encouraging, and there's no collaboration, but a rather different kind of setup. So, but you do have to see that dependent on the case, the whole process may be entirely different. So we had human rights organizations, for instance, in this one case, formulating documents for us or just supporting us regarding these search lists with the Tor server operators. And so you can find different forms of support, but so we're obviously doing the technical analysis. But like the legal work was then taken over by human rights lawyers from International Human Rights Watch. But I mean, that's the benefit, but also it's more interaction and communication overhead. So we do have an ongoing debate about how heavily do we want to get into this, but clearly Snowden was a singularity in this sense. That, but also good opportunities to find some maybe generic positions or make some quite clear technological social statements. But this is still a running thing. So don't sue, but fight maybe.
wie es auch der CCC in Freiburg macht in Form von Vorträgen.
Hier ist wieder ein and sehr, sehr schönes Beispiel. This CCC, an active Alpha Circle, a local circle in Freiburg in the south of Germany. So they do what's called a Chaos Talk, a talk format, and additional crypto parties and cooking events or something. And so this is just an example for a project. But now Chaos Dorf, they're in Düsseldorf. This is a real a sweet hack. What they did is they became a little ISP in their own right. Let's give them a hand.
Man sollte das nicht unterschätzen, das könnte noch mal sehr sehr nützlich sein.
So don't underestimate that to have a little Düsseldorf ISP might become useful.
Provider finde ich super genial.
And so Freifunk developed from an Alpha Circle has become a little ISP of its own. So, August, it remains cold.
So they actually admitted to surveilling like one of the control commissions. And yeah, maybe that apparently they had some free time or free resources. Glenn Greenwald declined to go there, and by saying that the Crown witness, like Snowden, wasn't going to be there anyway or wouldn't be heard. Gamma was hacked, so the support forum by Finn Fischer was available in the.
Es wurde bekannt, dass der BND
ein Telefonat
von Hillary Clinton versehentlich abgehört hatte und alle
BND, the German Intelligence Agency, apparently, unfortunately, messed up to disclose that they, by accident, listened to a telephone call by Hillary Clinton.
Öffentlich erstmal so ein bisschen zurückhalten zu der digitalen Agenda Stellung zu nehmen.
And then the digital agenda was published by the German new German government, and you know, we didn't really say anything to that at first because there was actually not much to say, and yeah, then we couldn't really stop ourselves to comment, but
in dieser Troika, geh mal nochmal ein zurück bitte.
But I'm also kind of annoyed by the fact that with these three guys, yeah, they always saying like such a great digital agenda, and
die Wanke? Also wieso haben die eigentlich die Bildungsministerin denn nicht dazugenommen, wenn sie schon irgendwie den großen visionären Entwurf machen wollen?
But apparently the Ministry of Education that is kind of lacking if they want to be that great, and the Ministry of Justice is not there. So maybe I just guess that they knew best about the internet, while the rest were sick.
Aber eigentlich sollten nicht eigentlich alle Minister auch Internetminister?
All ministers be internet ministers as well? Yeah, it's, you know, it's 2014. Don't give them ideas. They're listening. Maha said it in his talk on the first day. With his Twitter account, we kind of recreated the cyber soul of speaker of the ministry. It's Stefan Seibert, and so we made him say some nice statements like, "Let's use chances of the digitalization and."
Cyber.
Everything cyber and cybercrime and competences has to be extended and.
Zum Teil, wie wir sehen, an den Retweets sehr populär sind.
Wir prüfen und fördern gezielt die Potenziale.
We check and support the potentials of digital Africa. Yeah, and in a specific manner.
Das bürgerschaftliche Engagement verlagert sich mehr ins Netz mit der wachsenden Bedeutung des Internets. Wer konnte damit rechnen?
Ja.
Und für die Digitalisierung des
Energiebereichs of the energy sector,
the nicht, was das
Energy, the energy. Eine Energiewende, like August, switching to alternative fuels is very important. Then there was the Freiheit statt Angst, Freedom instead of Fear demo. Like the organizers said 6,000 demonstrators were there, or activists.
Anschlusstreffen nach dieser Demonstration wurde sich dann auch mal after damit auseinandergesetzt.
At a meeting after the demonstration, there was debate about why such a broad breadth of organizations did not manage to get more people out on the streets.
Organisations- und Protestformen konzentrieren möchte.
So the consensus is probably that in the next years they will focus on different kinds of activities and protests. And so maybe that's just going out and walking is not really appropriate more for the importance and danger of the topic.
Politischen Forderungen Nachdruck.
So we are excited to know what we'll come up with next year. And this is also a call to everybody to use technology in a different way. And like if you saw the talk by Centrum for Digital Beauty, and we need new creative forms of protests,
new
like new friends that help us, and with all forms of protest, it's important that it has to be fun. If it's not fun, then you know, if you can't see it from a humorous side, then maybe you should just move abroad, or I don't know.
Wir müssen uns ja auch eigentlich unseren Journalismus quersubventionieren.
Yeah, so
hat der Chaos Computer Club noch mal ein bisschen Geld ausgegeben.
We have to finance our own journalism with subsidies.
Als Anbieter von Infrastruktur, aber auch Netzpolitik.org, die diese Form von Aktivismus, Journalismus betreiben.
So we helped out Netzpolitik.org as well, as they are like
friends
and very close to us.
Generell hat der CCC in diesem Jahr mehr andere
Aktivisten unterstützt als sonst. CCC did a lot of support for fellow activists, and maybe that's also because we just had more money to help out others.
Sondern eben auch den Beschluss der Mitgliederversammlung um.
So we helped Netzpolitik.org and also helped out Chelsea Manning and Edward Snowden. Not only with the honorary membership,
angenommen haben, alle beide also, über die Anwälte vermittelt und dass wir aber auch gleichzeitig 36.000
Euro
Team
to the European Team of the Legal Defense of Edward Snowden
zu spenden. Das war der Beschluss der Mitgliederversammlung.
And that was a decision by the members assembly of the CC.
Die legalistische Seite dazu unterstützen.
So we try to support the legal side of things that help him with like the various his various needs.
Allein auch ein Link am letzten Tag, wer sich da interessiert, wird es ja ein Update geben für den Fall von Chelsea Manning, wo der
so there'll be an update on the case of Chelsea Manning and there's a light at the end of the tunnel. So if you're interested in that, you can watch, listen at day 4.
Weiter geht's mit schönen Veranstaltungen aus dem Chaosumfeld.
So we continue with beautiful events at the Chaos Computer Club. This is the ICMP Intergalactic Martyr Party. You can also do a pilgrimage there. It's the Golden Source, that's how it's called. This event takes place every 2 years.
ist eine extrem schöne, gemütliche,
so it's a very comfortable, ja, beautiful and fun event.
Bitte? Draußen. Ach so, genau.
Outside, outdoor. Also
frische Luft und so, so und auch
fresh air.
Und alles, was dazu gehört,
lot of mosquitoes. All the environment, but it's very colorful.
Tolle Aktivitäten.
So a lot of interesting activities you can do there.
Wo? In Münchsteinach.
Münchsteinach. You don't know that? Excuse me.
Metropole
im Süden. So, yeah. It's written on the Club Mate bottles.
Ungefähr ist, aber sag doch mal.
So I know more or less where it is, but where exactly is it? So yeah, you can read this on every Club Mate bottle. This is where Club Mate, the famous drink, is produced. So we continue with the project Full Circle. This has been realized with the CCC Mannheim in Kaiserslautern at the world famous ITWM in Kaiserslautern. We did blinking lights there. This is an open source project, and I can invite everyone to contribute. And do more.
Dann hatten wir dieses Jahr so ein
Ereignis, year, there was an event,
der Club sich echt erstaunlich zurückgehalten hat, irgendwie zu kommentieren, was ich sehr schade finde.
Modest in commenting, which I regret.
Meine Meinung dazu, und ich denke, opinion,
and I think a lot of people in this panel will share this. Outside, on the internet,
Literatur, Bilder, Videos von
Literature, pictures, literature by adults from all, by all genders and sexes, who voluntarily sell or give away intimate pictures. There's no reason, and this is incompatible with hacker ethics.
Nein, dass dass Fotos von Prominenten, sehr private Fotos von Prominenten,
very private pictures of prominent people. To publish them, and of course you can download them and jerk off to them, but then you're an asshole, basically. I think you have to say it that boldly, or straightforwardly, because that's part of the hacker ethics. It's the definition of private data that have to be protected. If you're in love, if you're horny, and record pictures, and then because you have the wrong operating system, they're automatically uploaded, then nobody who proudly calls themselves a hacker has the right to play around with these. So I think, well, there has been in the hacker family a juvenile nonchalance with this case, and I think this can be seen in other developments like Gamergate. There's sort of like a trend towards the dehumanization of people who are only personas online. Those are no longer people. Those are not women who criticize gamer culture. But they become subjects which you can confront with rape threats and violence. On the other hand, a lot of gamers are portrayed in a very homogeneous way. They're perceived as a mass of people and not as individuals. So I think we need to take a step back, be empathetic, and see people on the other end of the line as people with sensibilities, perspectives that should be reflected before.
In alle Richtungen dort sich Entgleisungen leisten.
Before you're shooting in all various ways, which can't be taken back.
So, wir wissen ja, dass wir jetzt kommen.
Wer ein Erfa kennt,
who knows a local club, Erfa, or who knows in one or is active in one, in the Chaos Computer Club, knows
Menschen,
that within these local clubs,
nicht angenommen werden,
we serve as points where people maybe not accepted in other communities
to have a safe space to Umgebung ins Reine zu kommen und ihre,
become at peace with their immediate environment, to realize their potential.
I'm
extremely pissed off
when
I see how parts of this community interact with each other.
Und bei uns
especially here,
Gerade in unserer Community,
especially in this community,
I think we should be
sensibilized.
Fähigkeiten so umzugehen und irgendwie andere Menschen anzugreifen.
And
ich denke, da sind wir uns einig, dass das hier nichts verloren
hat. Don't attack other people with our real or imagined skills. So I think the good message is. The good message is that even though the debate has been led very differently in the English language speaking space, people are talking about why things have changed, why they have become so violent, why tone has changed and become so violent. I think it's a very good sign that we notice this and talk about it, that it's not a non-topic. So I think discussion culture within our club and sometimes external communication is sometimes a bit difficult. But I think if we are debating this, we should be an active part in this debate. However, this should be done in a good spirit.
Stattfindet.
And we don't need a division of the club.
Will ich gar nicht erst
what do you mean?
Okay.
Wir gehen
mal zum nächsten Thema über. Wir haben den September.
So, next topic.
Der September. Die VG September. Media scheiterte mit ihrer Kartellbeschwerde gegen
VG Google. Media is, didn't succeed in their claims against Google.
Oh.
Kartell.
German provider who were hacked by the NSA were confronted in front of the camera, and you really should watch that video. The first search result, machines. Asked the Leistungsschutzrecht publishers, wants that Google wants to publish his algorithms, but apparently just one. The first BND member who entered was in the BND Ausschuss, but he wasn't allowed to say anything. The opposition wanted to force to ask Leo Snowden.
Also ist ja vollkommen klar, er hat's ja auch selber.
It's very clear, and he also submitted that he was the worst candidate or the least competent of this post, but we know for quite some time that competence is not important anymore. And several interesting things have happened, etc. Yeah. So, of course, the decisions in Brussels are getting more important, not only in the data protection, but also in many other departments. Also about the copyright.
Yeah, das ist unser neuer Spezialexperte in Brüssel.
So he's our new special expert in Brüssel. Also important looking are people at the Datenspuren from CCC at Dresden, where you can enter free and you get free hugs and free stickers. So if you're there, do visit it. It will also happen next year. There also the following project was presented. So some problems are just solved by the hacker community. The project PEP that just wants to make all this crypto stuff easy. So some people from the club decided to and just wrote some source code and just used the data traces to find this project. So they made a crowdfunding project. So sometimes in the club, groups form and they want to make a really nice project and want to make a commercial valuable project out of that. So it was really viewed good as it was presented on the data traces. So the next big work is from the motto was the MRMCD. They happen in September in Darmstadt. This year we had the motto, the big job IT security, so we had 300 entrance permits. not security is first. We had with rooms with the big names like S21, a big.
So
we had 450 devices at the NOC, and more data was sent than received. And also we cared about the most important topics like discussing. So, James just worked starting Sunday. So, what else happened in September? September is also with a lot happens. In U23 in Cologne, the young hacker go there and make fun projects. This time another big project was Freifunk, where a new hacker in Cologne and around Cologne created a free Wi-Fi network, and there you also see with these images also a hacker has to go into the church and climb on the tower and create a network for the community. And that was a nice action in Cologne. Then came the October. And it stays cold.
In
October, Iconal happened so that the BND did listen at the C6. FTDI turned off the driver's connection via driver updates. And Avramopoulos wants to return the preemptive saving of data. So we assume that 2015 they will try again under a different name, but two people who outed themselves as wanting it. So it will be called something different, like minimal saving requirements or so, but the CCC Aachen made a quite interesting project. There is sensors which are mandatory in every new project, which don't only measure the pressure of the tire, but also send it further on. And the CCC Aachen looked at the technology critically and found several issues in the implementation, which were with self-built hardware, could functionally be used differently, and you could from a safe distance in a dim environment could show them that the tire pressure was reduced. So we don't want to know what really happened. It's really well documented. In Karlsruhe, there was a theater play which looked about the services and the effort.
Entropia.
Ja, das war das Wort, was ich gesucht habe, die Entropia.
It was called Entropia, and they created an NSA timeline for many meters for the theater, which is also quite interesting. Okay, it has to be extended. So they see clearly hackers are also artists.
Dann hat der
C3 Paderborn
eine Veranstaltung ausgerichtet mit dem Titel Die Älteren erobern das Netz.
Made an action where they called The Elderly Use the Network, and it's for teaching the older how to use the Internet. And it was done with the
Opferschutz
Commissariat of Data of Protection of the People from the Police. So nowadays we do cooperate with the police. We can't disclaim that anymore.
So
that's the healthy opposite piece for chaos goes to school. And I have also said that at the opening. So
besser die Hände reichen
müssen, we have to reach those generations the hands to get them into the network, because you need help nowadays if you can't control computers. So you all know that from home probably.
In October
the hackover happened in Hannover. It's a congress in small. They made it really professional.
Das unser Konferenzplanungswerkzeug ist.
They
die Aufzeichnung der Vorträge, über 30 Stück, gab es am Ende oder gibt es am Ende jetzt auf media.ccc.de.
The videos are available on media.ccc.de. They were
komplett ausverkauft. Das ziemlich cool ist.
It was completely sold out.
Wie auf den vorletzten Kongress
und like on the last Congress, there were badges that you could play one with yourself with the firmware. Demoscene nearly took over this project, and they talked about the history, and they did several demos and analog demos, which was a really great hack. And that were all my notes for that. So then we reach November. It gets colder. So it was got public that the BND wants to use exploits and use it against their people and don't want to work towards closing those bugs. The mount was supposed to save movement profiles for 13 days.
Der NSA-Skandal in den USA scheiterte im Senat daran, 60 Stimmen für die Fortführung der Diskussion zu bekommen.
In the US, there is no Secret Service reform because they failed to reach 60 votes to continue the discussion. But on the other hand, Obama wants to work against foreign net neutrality, but he has no real power about that. WhatsApp implements end-to-end cryptography, and thereby it's more secure than D-mail. The world is so strange. The BKA-Chef Zierke goes into
aber natürlich nicht ohne die Vorratsdatenspeicherungsdebatte noch einmal gemeinsam mit Innenminister de Maizière.
But not without talking about preemptive saving of memory. So now there's Holger Münch. And the British porno filter is extended to terror propaganda, and that's going to be interesting the next month.
Dann natürlich hier
then,
noch ein Bild.
Of course, Ungarn wants to put a tax on internet traffic, but they decided quickly to do it, not to do that.
Andere aufgreifen Internetsteuer, das klingt ja schon.
Internet tax will be used by different people.
Ja, diese Terrorfilter.
These terror filters are a reason why the Chaos Computer Club completely in the pre-sale phase of this conference. Oh.
Das war die Reihenfolge nicht eingehalten.
Da war ich nicht zu schnell.
Did not keep with the order. Oh, there's a different. The BND suddenly had an issue when it became public what other secret services did. They were pretty sure that they said, hey, we want that too. And so they just went ahead, and without thinking about whether they wanted to stop themselves, they said, hey, we want more money. And after they noticed what the other secret services already do, because computer systems are insecure, and they worked towards that, they said, we also want to join that, and we want money to buy 0 days. We want to have the opportunity to install software and computers of suspects, which is a clear case, which is illegal under the IT law, ground law. And so they wanted more money to buy 0 days. So in the beginning, we had no had no words about that, and in the end we commented about that, but it's a no-brainer. That's not a good idea. it should be the job of the to help his people as fast as possible and not to just keep it. And it is unlikely that the BND from all other secret services would use it cleanly and that it doesn't just disappear as used by others. So I have no words for that. 4.5 million euros.
4.5 million euro sind dafür vorgesehen in dem
requested.
In dem beantragten Budget. Aber der
But
die tatsächlichen Kosten sind
the real costs were significantly larger. Because what we always have to say is that if you buy a zero day and want to use it, you have
Sicherheitslücke von den Systemen verschwindet. Das heißt,
must work that it does not these issues don't disappear. So the price we pay for that in the end is significantly larger because the security issue is still there.
Was da bekannt wurde,
so what became public was that they wanted to become more technically available. So it's mostly, oh, we know now what the NSA has to play with and we want the same. And also about how they want to their own biometric capabilities and they want to advance that.
And
they want to make face recognition more popular and they want to work how to work around biometrical systems to get into the US. So the BND is in the Christmas mode at the moment.
Noch mal kurz über die Abschaffung zu reden, dann machen wir bei der FIF kommen.
Okay, so, let's just carry on.
Ja, der CCC ist ja nun mittlerweile schon ein relativ alter Verein, das heißt, wir müssen uns ein bisschen um unsere Geschichte kümmern.
As a meanwhile, quite old club, we obviously have to care about our own history a bit and evaluate that, so revisiting.
Und dieses Jahr gab es eine Veranstaltung der Holland-Stiftung, die der CCC auch unterstützt hat,
so,
wo es darum ging, nochmal an den BTX
in real historical terms, we did have an action this year, an activity or event to remind of the legendary BTX hack, which actually contributed to the name of the CCC and the development, if you remember. This was actually a bank in Hamburg. You must have heard about it. And then we had another nice event. I think this was the third time that this took place, and we honor interesting methods or unconventional methods. I think it was the troll of the year. And so this year it was an anti-neo-Nazi organization. So this troll event is taking place and it's a big fun thing, and for the fourth time you can check it out. It's highly ironic. So our video center recorded another event. This was the FIFCON. FIFCON is a German organization for, well, computer scientists for peace. Peace and social responsibility. So it's a club, and yes, I did practice that name. It's a, but I think the topic that well, they have a broader political and social interests, but I think the event this year, FIFCON, recently did have a very, very clear focus on the surveillance and interception track. So we do, of course, have all the recordings, and there were legal experts commenting in particular on the Secret Service, on situations, and this is available, and you can get all the videos and all the recordings, so it's worthwhile to check it out.
Den Mann des Monats November vorzustellen.
Oh, I just neglected to honor the man of the month in November. This was Axel Springer, big German editing house. So Leistungsschutzrecht, the ancillary copyright law, which is supposed to give publishers an extra benefit for being found in search engines. Well, and we congratulate. This has been like the most successful failure ever. And we're not sure what he means, but Mr. Duffner was very happy about the Leistungsschutzrecht. It was a big joke, but yeah, I'm sure you remember. Oh yeah, December. Let's smash Google. We have a query. We had an inquiry within the NSA commission, the inquiry commission. So one of the questions was, like the factual questions: what is it that the US are actually charging Snowden with? And the response was, well, for the German Secret Service inquiry, well, this isn't really a relevant question, so we're not actually answering the question. So this is the kind of policy or communication protocol, just as an example. So the Secret Services are evaluating. So we do just keep the option open that you can still take that extra step to go to the Human Rights Court, and the UK situation in particular. There are a few openings, or just a few possibilities to grab them by the balls. I mean, obviously, to target them appropriately. Another highlight: Angela Merkel, German Chancellor, says another ending for net neutrality, says it's over, and they're giving it to Erdgeist. Okay, right, now it's me. People were worried in the UK. They wanted to acquire tickets for the event, for this.
Der Chaos Computer Club in UK
for this procedure and
Mauerblümchen Pornografie Begrenzung etablierten Filter plötzlich auf der Liste gelandet sind.
Well, it was quite an interesting procedure, because what was on the list before was, well, maybe even vanilla-ish kind of porn URL lists, etc. And well, then other contexts were discovered, and actually, content was you know, censored in that sense. So, but 2 weeks later, we'd already been unlisted again from these providers. But I think just the attitude of just overreach and overreacting, this was just a coincidence that we found out, but which gave us the opportunity to protest that. But you don't know what happens. I mean, if you just stay on this list, you can make automated checks, but this is just an incident where you can really tell what kind of weapons are maybe for a very small procedure, because we're certainly not a terror or porn organization. But it's highly visible. It's interesting to see which providers or ISPs are actually actively blocking us in the UK. So valuable for analysis. So moving on, the photo you just saw briefly here was an object.
All die Sachen, die ihr hier auf einem Kongress,
an exhibition piece. So if you see the video, if you think of all the stuff that arrives here every year and what's going on, we can't obviously leave it lying around in the Congress Center here in Hamburg all year long. And this is like the accelerated activity you can see there. So we're actually transporting all this stuff back to Berlin. And there's quite a lot of logistics and effort involved, as you can maybe see by this ant-like activity. And so we have additional space. This is the Chaos Computer Club in Berlin, about a quarter of the local members, to packing up, repacking, all that stuff that we don't want to, you know, throw away, just to put it into storage. These are the new storage spaces in Berlin. And this is something which is still like standing around. It's not heated. It could have dropped off. It didn't fit on the truck anymore. And this beautiful Trojan horse with the German government, the Bundestrojaner, is still like standing around and freezing.
Schluss, Macht, Schluss.
But we have to do a lot of actions and, you know, getting stuff from A to B and Hauruck.
So that's like the result if I hit print with the printer doing the Datenschleuder, our members magazine. Then some days later there will be two big pallets of paper in the front of my door, and I had a problem that I didn't have before. To the members. And before we have to get it to a cooperating school for the disabled that helps with putting it in envelopes and sending it out. And I wanted to do some logistics and give it to the Federal Post and help them with it, but that didn't really work. Like, they didn't find a way to bring a lorry by my place. So CEDAX actually rented a lorry and got all the stuff from my place and got it on its way. Now, it was a nice surprise just before Congress for everybody. Of course, you can get it here as well. Like in some cases of the club work, it's getting problematic if the member base grows with printing more stuff. And so one request, please, if you don't have your address right, like there's a few people sitting in Mannheim, so they have to, like, if they have returns, like 400 Datenschleuders were returned, then, you know, we get it back, and we had to increase our postbox size because of all the Datenschleuders coming back. So please, if you can just change your address, that makes everything much easier for us. Thank you. So, and that's like finally the end of the year. I think in all was a successful year, but of course there's always things you don't like. But you want to continue the good work. But of course this Congress motivates me a lot to keep going, and yeah, I think we will continue with our work, and we hope for your support and the next year.